going to show you how to do an IV push. Before you do your skill, there are several things that you want to check. Of course, you want to check your doctor's order and always do your 6 rights or 10 rights or however many medication rights you've been told. And then you want to introduce yourself to your patient, identify your patient, and find out a few things. Find out if your patient has any allergies to the medication you're giving. Do any assessments that are appropriate for the medication. For example, if you're giving a medication that might decrease their respiratory drive, make sure that they're breathing well right now and that they have a good respiratory rate right now. If you are giving a medication in addition to a fluid or a medication that's already running, then make sure you check compatibility. In this case, we are just using an NS lock, and so as long as my medication is compatible with normal saline that I'm pushing before and after, then I am good to go. Always educate your patient before you give the medication. Find out if they've ever had it before, tell them what it's for, teach them a couple of side effects to watch out for. Sometimes you'll find out that they actually can't have this medication, or maybe there's been an interaction in the past, and so always teach before you give the med, not after. And so that brings us to this point where we're ready to give the medication. If you haven't already performed hand hygiene, do so. It's always a good idea to wear gloves, even though we are not very likely to be exposed to blood or body fluids. So the actual process of giving an IV push is pretty simple. It's just flush, med, flush. First thing we want to do is clean off our access clave, scrub the hub, just really wrap the alcohol wipe around it and scrub kind of in a corkscrew method for 15 to 30 seconds. This surface can carry a lot of bacteria. Then you want to get your first flush, take off the lid, which is on nice and tight because this has not been used before. It's okay, makes it real. You see how I'm keeping a hold of the clave? I need to make sure that the clave doesn't accidentally touch the patient's skin or the bed. So always keep a hold of that. Attach your flush and flush 3 to 5 milliliters, just to determine patency, to get any medication that could be sitting in the line out. Then you get your medication, which you have previously drawn up in a correct size syringe for the dose. In the same manner, not touching the ends, attach your medication. Push your medication according to the instructions that you looked up when you were researching your medication and looking in the drug guide. If it says to push it over 2 minutes, push it over 2 minutes. Once you have your medication pushed, you're ready to do your second flush, just to get the rest of that medication in. So keep in mind that if you had to push your medication slowly, that you're gonna have to push this second flush slowly as well. Okay, if you have to set down your clave, this is a good teaching point to get your flush. Then you're gonna need a new alcohol wipe and you're gonna need to clean your clave again. So if you ever set it down, clean it again, 15 to 30 seconds. Then your post-flush, at the same rate as you pushed your medication, 3 to 5 mils, and then end with clamping off your line if you're not gonna use it. If you have one of those alcohol caps at the facility you work at, you can add an alcohol cap to the end of the clave, and you're done.